Hi team, welcome to Automation for Testers. In this lecture, we are going to talk about different iteration methods like for each, entries, keys and values. Okay. So now in order to understand better, we'll take a look at the demo in the Visual Studio code. So now I have declared one array variable arr equal to, I have added some values inside of it. Okay, so now we have already discussed about for each, but still we are just trying to recap what exactly it is. If you are not sure about the syntax, what you can do, simply say for, and after that you can see it is giving you what suggestions over here. So in that we need to select this for each and say enter. Then you can see it has given you the complete syntax how to use it. So we all know we have our object name is what, arr. So here we have to provide what, arr only. So this is what array name that you have to give it. So after that you have to use for each keyword, and we all know it will take what, one callback function. So in the callback function there are some parameters are available, but here we are making use of only one, which is called as what, element over here. You can give any name, a, b, c, you can give any name, there is no restriction for you at all. This is like a parameter and it's a arrow function. There you can see it is a callback function that you have over here. So here in the method body you have to write your logic, or else if you want to print it also, simply say log and then element. Okay, so it here the name of this element is not mandatory. You can give I, A, B, C, anything is fine. Okay, so now let's try to run the program and see what is the output we are going to get. There you can see this is a very basic one, and you know, very easy one to use in arrays. Okay, this is what for each is all about. Okay, so now let's talk about the second method. What we have, guys? Values, right? So if I take a look at over here, they can see entries, guys. Sorry, entries. Okay, so now arr dot entries. Okay, here if you put the cursor over here, they can see returns an iterable object of key value pairs. What exactly it is giving? What key value pairs for every entry in the array. There you can see the output is what, iterable iterator number and number. So in order to print these values, there you can see you can use for. Okay, so now here in for you can say what we will do, we'll try to say element, or else we'll do something like this, for of, and this object is what, arr, right? So try to print it log, let's say this is variable only, right? So now here print it and see what is the output we are going to get it. So based on the output we'll try to modify it. It is giving you what, guys? All the output it is giving, one second, it is for entries. So our method is what, entries, right? So we have to give like this, my bad guys. So cls, try to rerun your program. There you can see 0, 20, 1, 10, and like this it is giving you key and value pair. So that means this iterator is what, it's not a single variable, it's like an array kind of thing. There you have two elements. Okay, so in order to do it correctly, what we can do, we can do something like this, variable key comma variable key comma value. You can give any name, I comma j, a comma b, anything is fine, as long as you know it is giving us the output. So you can see key comma value. I'm just printing on the console. Okay, so cls, try to run your program. What exactly it is giving you, guys? You can remove this, one second guys. There you can see it is giving you what, key and value of it. Okay, so now here that you need to understand is this will give you what, complete key and value pairs. It's a little strange and new to us. If you are coming from Python background, that's fine, you can understand this one very well, but if you are coming from regular Java background, this will be something new for you. Okay, so entries will give you what, key value pairs. This thing you need to understand. Okay, so this one, whatever is being written, that is called as what, this is a complete array, right? So if you print it in the normal way, if I print like this, variable I, and try to print only the I over here and try to rerun your program, there you can see it is giving you what, key and value. That means each and every output of this entry is something like a one more array for us. like a one more. There you can see it is a symbol for array, right? So this is is equivalent to array for us. So each and every iteration will give you what? Array which contains key and also which contains value. So in order to handle that, what we have done? We are storing in the key and value variables. Okay, like this, the entry variables, entry methods will help you to get the keys and values as well. Okay, so now let's jump on to the third method that we have. Which method we have, guys? Keys. Okay, so same thing, you can apply for of. Here you can constant, I am not telling because we have not discussed about. So you can use any name, ISTs. So here you can say arr.keys. Now put the cursor over here. What is the output it is giving? What is the message it is giving? Return an iterable of keys in the array. That means it will give you only the keys, guys. So it is not give you the something like what we can say key value pairs. Only key you will be getting. That means in this case you will be getting only what? 0, 1, 2, 3, right? So CLS, try to run your program. There you can see, like this, you can get it. If you want the values also, you can simply say arr of iterator. That's it. So try to run your program. CLS, the name itself is indicating keys. That means it will give you only key. But entry is what? Key and value. So understand the difference between keys and entries. Control Shift A. And we have one more method also. Same thing. All you need to do is simply what? Instead of keys, we have something called what? Arr dot values. Now let's try to see the output, what exactly it is coming first. Okay, so now let's try to print iterator only. I am not printing these values. Now CLS, try to run your program. There you can see a direct value only you are getting, so you don't need to worry about the indexes. Okay, so like this, you can use these four methods to get different things from it. Like if you want for each, you will get each and every value. And we in the earlier session we also discussed about what is mean by for each and for off. What exactly difference does it make? Those things will apply here also. Okay, so but the methods we are discussing about what? Entries, keys and values. So entries will give you key value pair, keys will give you only keys of an array, and value gives only what? Value of an array. Okay, so these four methods we have discussed. Okay, so I hope the session is helpful for you guys. Thanks for joining the session.